Good morning, everybody. Afternoon, night, wherever you are in the day. I hope you are having a fabulous day. Today we have redline for you guys. This is going to be my first time actually taking this class and not just coaching it. So if you guys are joining for the first time or this is your first time taking redline, I am with you guys. So the way redline works is it's a cardio-based exercise, cardio-based class. We will have 9 movements. We are basically working for 3 minutes and 10 seconds. So the way that those increments are broken up is our first set is going to be 20 seconds of work, 5 seconds of rest. Then we'll have 30 seconds of work, 5 seconds of rest. We go up by 10 seconds until we get to a 60-second work interval, and then we will have 20 seconds of rest in between and go straight on all the way through the 9 movements. All right, first movement up. We have a squat with a transverse lunge. So I don't think we've done any transverse lunges with you guys, so I'm gonna walk you guys through it. Grabbing our dumbbells here, I have 2 15s. If you guys just wanna use one dumbbell or a lighter pair of dumbbells, I highly suggest that since we are working for long periods of time. So we have a squat and a transverse lunge. We're gonna step back 45 degree angle right here. We're going to lean into that leg, stepping back, front leg stays straight. So squat, step back into that 45, lean into that 45 right there, and then we come right back. That's our first movement. Right after that, we are dropping to the ground. We have 10 mountain climbers into 2 push-ups. So just driving our knees to our chest here. Once we get 10, we drop into those 2 push-ups. Movement number 3, we have 4 lateral shoot throughs, 10 reverse crunches. So for our lateral shoot throughs, we are getting our leg parallel to the floor. Try and get that butt to the ground. We hit 4 here, then we hop straight onto our back. Reverse crunches, hi Arwen. Reverse crunches, we bring our elbows to our knees. It's early in the morning, they haven't gone on their walk yet. So they are, she's excited. All right, movement number 4, we have thrusters. For this movement, I highly recommend using a lighter weight. Since we are working for longer periods of time, it's gonna be really hard to maintain that heavy weight. So for a thruster, we squat, push, using that momentum in our legs to get that weight overhead. Right after that, we have 3 skaters into 1 burpee. Team today, watch out. For our skaters, we're shooting it from side to side. Once we hit that 3rd, we drop down into a burpee, we get right back up. 1, 2, 3, making sure we're alternating which side we're doing our burpee on, that's why we have 3. All right, after that, we have a yogi push-up. So for the yogi push-up, we start in high plank position right here. We send our butt back, we come right back up to the high plank position. We drop into push-up, send that butt back, drop into push-up. Movement number 7, we have an RDL with a reverse lunge. This is a little slower movement, so you guys are more than welcome to go a little bit heavier here. So we have an RDL and then go straight into the reverse lunge. RDL, reverse lunge, making sure we're alternating which leg is going back. Movement number 8, we have a V up. So we're dropping it down, touching our toes to our fingers. Really trying to balance on that butt as we come up. Ultimate goal is getting the full back off the ground as well as getting your legs off the ground. Then finishing it off with a clean plus a burpee. So one dumbbell here, we're going to be cleaning to a press, drop down, give me that burpee. Alternate hand, clean to press, drop down, give me a burpee. That is redline for you guys. I'm being a little bit more quiet because it's 8 a.m. and my neighbors are still sleeping. So let's get ready to warm up. All right, guys, let's come on out and warm up. All right, let's just start with low tempo punching. Let me adjust the camera a little bit. Move a little too far down. Keep giving me that low tempo punching, good. Just warming that body up. Man, I'm sore from last week. I don't know how many classes you guys took last week. Boy, my quads, my hamstrings, shoulders, so sore. All right, give me a wide stance, arms wide. Touch opposite toe, opposite hand. Good. Just waking the body up right now. right, next up, give me a squat with a rotation. So we're dropping it low, coming up, rotating at the top. I have a little helper today. Arwen's gonna be my assistant coach. We'll see how long she actually stays. Good. Let's get two more. Last one here. All right. Bring those feet wide, hands on the ground, and shifting from side to side. Oh gosh. So we get a little bit of our hamstring, a lot of our groin. Good. Everything is so sore right now. All right, wrap those fingers under those toes. Give me a deep squat and send the hips high. I mean, if you can't tell, I'm just stretching for myself right now. My body is so sore. All right, good. Give me three more here. We have one, two, three. All right, now give me that high plank. Give me an arm rotation with a push-up. Good. We don't need to move quickly through this, we're just waking up. Good. All right, last one here. All right, walk those hands back into your feet. Ooh, give me a nice roll up. Up twist. And we'll start getting that heart rate up. I started with the slower movement for this. Personally, that's the only way like to start my workouts, with slower movement, so I can like get into it. People always say that's what the warm-up's for. It's like, mentally, no. The warm-up, I'm still waking up. The workout, I still need to like ease my way into it. All right, two, one, give me drop squats. Good. We're getting that heart rate up, everyone. Three more here. Two, one, jumping jacks. Good. Almost there. Two, one, and rest. All right. Jacket is coming off. Yeah, jacket's coming off. It's like in between weather right now, I'm not sure. All right, guys. So grabbing those weights, I recommend a medium to a little bit lighter. So like I said, today is cardio-based. When we do cardio-based, we're really not trying to move heavy weights. When we have weights, it's just for a little bit resistance to slightly slow the movement down. So I'm gonna be moving 15s, but I might drop one and just do one dumbbell. So I'll let you know. But I'm starting with two 15 dumbbells. All right, guys. So first movement up, we have that squat with a transverse lunge. We are on in three, two, one. Let's go. Let's make sure we're alternating. Like I said, when we step back, front leg stays straight, back leg does all the work. We're just stepping into that back leg. Good. And rest. Our recoveries are quick. All right, let's go. Remember, we're adding 10 seconds each work period, and our rest is staying the same. So we still have 5 seconds in between. Good. Keeping that chest up. Not letting the weight pull you forward. Good. Really trying to sit back in that transverse lunge. Two, one, rest. Whew. I'm going to drop those weights for a little bit, but we're right back up. Let's go. Make sure we keep that gaze up the entire time. When our gaze starts to drop, our head drops, our chest drops. Let's keep that gaze up. Whew, arms. Might be time to drop a weight. Keep it up, everyone. We're looking good. We're almost done with our third set. 2, 1. All right. We're ditching one weight. Let's go. Fourth set here, guys. We have 50 seconds. Really try and keep that front leg straight as we step back. And we load that hip. We're still being mindful of our knee as we step back into that transverse lunge. We don't want our knee going outside of our ankle or traveling in front of that toe. Both directions is a hard stop. We want that knee perfectly over the ankle, weight in our heels. Great work, guys, 10 seconds. If you guys have the weight on your chest, really try and get those elbows up and rest. Ooh, we're almost there. One more set. Let's go. Last set here, everyone. So like I was saying, if you have that single weight on your chest, really try and get those elbows up. It's a good, just little long period of time where you can work on that front squat, as well as that flexibility in your wrists and your arms to get that weight up. Good. Keep alternating. Whew. All right, as we get tired, make sure we're still focusing on good quality reps here. I never want to see us sacrificing form to move quickly. So when we get tired, that's when we lock in and that's when we focus. Almost there. We have 5. Oh gosh. Goodness. All right, 20 seconds. We work our way to the floor. We have 10 mountain climbers, 2 push-ups. All right, 10 more seconds. Catch your breath. We're back in 3, 2, 1. First set, let's go. Hi, sweetie. Gosh, my shoulders feel tired. I hope you wake up. 2, 1, and rest. I hope you guys have a little helper at home like I do. Let's go, second set. Good, guys. Strong chest the entire time. We don't let that chest sink below our shoulders. Our hands are right underneath our shoulders in this movement. Elbows tight to the ribs, and they go straight back. They don't flare out. 5 seconds. And rest. 2, 1. Let's go. Third set. Good. Let's get those push-ups quick. Whew. You guys need to shake it out, that's all right. We get right back into it right after though. Whew, 12 to go. Good. One sit. And rest. One sit. All right, set number 4, let's go. Those arms. 20 seconds, let's go. almost there. Two, one, and rest. One more second. We got it. 60 seconds, and we're done. We keep the few movement cues for this. We keep our chest tight the entire time. I want to see a flat rack. So shoulder to shoulder, straight line as we push through. Our chest to floor, elbows go to the side, they shave the ribs. We keep the core tight, we keep our butt down. We're locked in the entire time, guys, good. Almost there, everyone. 15 to go. Through a full set. Start wherever you finished. We're evening out what we're doing. For the reverse crunch, I like to touch my tips of my fingers to the ground as well as my heels to the ground, and then elbows to knees. Good. Almost there, and rest. All right, we're back for set three. Let's go. Not gonna lie, the reverse crunches are a very nice break. Good, 15 to go. Almost there, five. Let's get one more in. Good work, guys. Two, one, we're back. Finish where you left off. Set number four. We have one more after this. Remember, leg is parallel to the floor. Butt kisses the ground. The closer your foot is to your butt, the quicker and easier you can transition through this movement. The further your foot is from your butt, less mobility you have, and the harder it's gonna be. But it's not a good kind of hard. With this movement, we wanna be quick, and we wanna have as much mobility as we can, and rest. Last set coming up. Let's work. Yeah, a lot of times, what I see people doing is their feet are all the way back here, and then when they go, they're super unstable and they're not giving quite the right form. So bring your knees in like a bear hold, and then we can get that good depth and mobility in this movement. Good, guys, 30 seconds to go. Hi, you helping me? Thank you. More than halfway, everyone. Keep it up. Under 15.
strong, guys. We have 3, 2, 1. Nice. All right, next, moving up, thrusters. I'm just gonna stick with one weight on this. I'm not trying to move heavy weights. I'm getting 115, go lighter, because we'd rather go for pace than weight for this. All right, we squat, use that momentum, press overhead. Good, guys. We're breathing. We exhale at the top and rest. Quick 5 seconds. We're right back into it. Let's go. Let's really try and get that depth in this. Tight. I don't want to see any backs rounding out. We stack the ribs, stack the hips. 2, 1. Set number 3 coming up. All right, let's work, guys. 40 seconds. I like to keep my feet about shoulder width apart. You guys could even go a little bit wider, but just a hair. This isn't like a wide stance movement. Good. Stay strong. Big, strong breath in. Big exhale out. Really use those legs. Rest. Set number 4 coming up. I'm gonna move a little bit closer for you guys. Drive through those legs, everyone. Full extension at the top. When we reach that full extension, that's when our core is super tight, locked in. Great work, everyone. Almost there. Use those legs. We're breathing through this. Oh gosh. What do we have? 15 to go. Guys, we're almost there. We got it. Whew. We got this. Finish strong. 2, 1. All right, we're back. Last set. 1 minute here. Let's work. Guys, can get elbows to knee. That's our ideal position at the bottom. Quick tap and then right to the top. We don't want our elbows resting on our knees. If you need to take a break, I prefer you taking it at the top. At least our core will still stay engaged when we're resting there. Got it, guys. Second set coming up, everyone. Let's go. As we're pushing through those skaters, really stick that landing. Challenge yourself to keep that leg off the ground. So we stick the landing, reach the leg behind us. It helps counterbalance the weight as we shift across. But since we have so many of these, this is a great time to work on our form and challenge ourselves where we haven't been able to before. We have 3, 2, 1. Oh. All right, let's work. Set number 3, everyone. Don't get sloppy in those burpees. We're still keeping that good form. Feet shoot up to the outside of the hands. So we have a nice strong base as we come up. Good, 15 to go. Strong. Make sure we keep breathing. Whew. Halfway. Whew. Take a little dog break if you need it. We're right back into it. Challenge yourself. Stick that landing, keep the leg off, let it travel out, opposite hand, opposite foot. Whoops. Gosh. Making a mess. Good. 40 seconds to go. Really drive across. Almost there. Finish strong. Let's finish rubber at. Yes. Oh gosh. All right, we have yogi push-ups. Drop to the floor. Catch your breath. So. Yogi push-ups, we send the hips back. We go to high plank, we drop the push-up. Really push your head through your arms in this movement, and then drop into that push-up. So hips go to heels, head goes down to the floor, drop into the push-up. And rest. 2, 1. Let's go. You guys have the option to play around with this movement. If your arms are dying like me, you're more than welcome to just come to high plank. When you feel like you have it in you, drop into that push-up. 15 to go. Good. Set, try and keep with me. Keep with this pace. Come on. We drop our hips, high plank. Hips, high plank. Hips, high plank. All right, hips, high plank, push up. Hips, high plank, push up. Hips, high plank, push up. Come on. Keep with me, everyone. You got it. More than halfway. Strong hips. Don't let them sag. I don't want to see me. Almost there. All right, let's work. Good. Ooh, quads. This is a sneaky quad movement. Those heels, head pushing through your arms. And rest. Last set coming up. All right, 60 seconds, let's go. Drive the hips back, head through the arms. You want to ideally get your heels back to your butt, head as close to the ground as you can. Tight as you come into that high plank. Good. 35 to go.
Dripping sweat and my hair is looking fabulous.
All right, we have that RDL to reverse lunge. We're alternating each time. Let's go. So we hinge at the hips, we drive up with our hips, and then give me that reverse lunge. Good. Nice break for our body here. Working the posterior chain and rest. Woo. All right, let's go. Sending those hips back, driving them forward, reverse lunge. Woo. Make sure we're switching sides. I did not right there, so I'm reminding you because I'm reminding myself. Keeping that chest up. 5 seconds. If you guys want, you're more than welcome to just drop a weight into a single dumbbell here. This isn't necessarily to move heavy weights for this movement. This is just to bring our heart rate down while still having an active recovery.
All right, keep working, everyone. Sorry for the malfunction. My camera just said that it was full, but we have 10 seconds left. Keep working.
Good. All right, 5 to go. 1, and rest. All right, we're back. 2, 1, let's go. Set number 4 here. So I'll give you guys this side view. Knees come to 90. Really try and get that back knee to the floor. Like I said, this is a slower movement, and since we have so much time during these work periods, let's really focus on that form. The back is flat, shoulders don't round forward, and by rounding I mean when we get here, our shoulders aren't dropping. Shoulders stay up with that chest. 15 to go. Core is tight. 3, 2, 1, rest. Woo, we only have one more here. 2, One, let's go. 60 seconds, guys. We got this. Be aware of where your front knee is. We don't want it wiggling back and forth. I feel like I've been talking a lot about this with you guys, but I've just been noticing a lot in class. A lot of people struggle with this. Their knee will jiggle back and forth. So let's be mindful of trying to anchor that down. This is gonna help a lot if you guys have any knee issues or stability issues. Good, halfway. As we go into that RDL, we have a neutral spine, neutral neck. We don't wanna be looking up. We wanna keep that gaze down. But our gaze also shifts as our chest comes up. Two, one, rest. Ooh, all right, dropping it to the ground. Maybe dog is saying good morning. All right, we have V-ups here, everyone. We're on in three, two, one, let's go. So, first option, both feet up. Second option, if that's too hard for you, we'll do alternating. And honestly, once we get tired, this might be what we're switching to, but let's try and stick with the two leg. We're back, set number two. Really try and get that back off the ground. Relax the neck as much as you can. I know it's hard as we're trying to pull forward, but we want our abs doing all the work in this movement. 10 seconds. Two, one. All right, I'm gonna switch to alternating right here because I feel my form is slipping a little bit. Good. We keep breathing, using our breath to help us through the movement, driving that belly button to the floor as we get into the top of our V. 15. Good. Keep it up, guys. Two, one, and rest. Woo! Stay on the ground. One, let's go. Fourth set here. One more after this. Woo! You need to take a break to really relax that neck. I totally get it. Just really try and focus on driving through your lower abs in this movement. Really intentionally focus your intentions on your lower abs. That helps me relax my neck. 15. Good, keep it up, everyone. We're almost there, we're under 10. And rest. Not gonna lie, guys, my form is getting sloppy. We're gonna lock it in here, 1 minute. Back to double leg. I'm gonna do double leg. One right, one left, and then a double. Strong. We're under 10. Let's go. Two. One. Last movement, guys. We have made it. All right, grabbing that single dumbbell. We have a clean to a press with a burpee. We're back in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. So clean to a press, drop it down, give me that burpee. Then you roll it over, other arm. Drop it down into a burpee. Rest. Woo. 2, 1, let's go. This is a nice one because it breaks up doing burpees. This is personally one of my favorite ways to do a burpee because it doesn't really quite feel like a burpee. Feel free to ditch it. You guys are more than welcome to just do this motion, drop into the burpee. We drive through the legs to get that weight up. We drop into the burpee. From this here, we stay low, we grab, drive through the legs, and push. Keep it up, guys. More than halfway. Drive through those legs. Good. Under 20. We got it here. Finish strong. We're under 10. 3, 2, 1. We have made it to our last set. Let's go. 1 minute, everyone. Ourselves. So focus on that drive in our legs and press core tight the entire time. This is an easy time to let the weight go back, to let that stomach flare out. We keep the core tight. We're stacked from the side. Keep it up, guys. Almost there. Finish strong. Let's get one more. One. Woohoo. Goodness gracious, guys. Today was no joke. You can tell how tired I get by how crazy my hair looks because I just stopped fixing it. But great work today, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. It has been a pleasure leading you guys through Redline today. I hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye.